Good morning and welcome to Trent Kids. My name's Sam. We've got a great session planned for you today, and I'm joined by Andy. Andy, just come on, it's fine.
I'm not coming on, Sam.
Look, no one's going to notice.
They will.
They won't. It's, you can barely see. It's totally fine.
Fine, I'll come on, but it's just more difficult than you think.
Yeah. So, what's this? What's going on here?
Well, I saw Dan and Beth's video last week, and I just thought they had some really small cars. It looked really fun, but I thought I wanted to get in it rather than like remote control.
Okay.
And I just got stuck.
Right. And have you tried like wiggling to get out?
Of course, I've tried. Every time I move, it just does this.
Oh, okay. Well, have you tried like pushing, trying to push yourself?
I pushed. Look, every time I push, just move forward.
Yeah. Right.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know, that is tricky actually. Well, I'll tell you what, let's go to the big dance off. I'll get some butter or something and we'll figure this out, and we'll definitely be ready by the time we come back. So off we go, let's go to the big dance off. We'll see you in a minute.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it, move it.
Something new, the Casper Slide Part 2, featuring the Platinum Band, and this time, we're gonna get funky. Turn it out, funky, to the left, take it back now, y'all, five hops this time, hop it out now, right foot, let's go, left foot, let's go, right foot again, right foot, let's go, left foot, let's go. Freeze! Everybody clap your hands.
Bring me down, can't numb. Bring me down, the love is too high. Bring me down, can't numb. Bring me down, I said.
Shuffling, shuffling.
I am. My back is killing.
I bet.
Yeah, it was proper stuck that time.
Yeah, yeah, you look rough.
I know. I don't think I'm going to do that again.
No?
Well, I can't promise, but you never know.
Anyway, moving on. A lot of you will have seen the video that we did on generosity some weeks ago. And what's been brilliant is that a lot of you have been sending in your emails about the stuff that you've been doing that has been really generous. And we really want to read some of them out.
Amazing. So we've got a couple of stories, which is great, about giving out some homemade food. So Karis and Bethany were both managed to give out some food to neighbours and people in their community. And Edward, he gave a thank you card and made some cookies for people in his local shop who'd been working really hard throughout lockdown. And we've got a picture of that as well.
That is fantastic. And we also have a story from Joel, who drew a picture for an elderly neighbour and took it round. And here's what he drew. That's so great. Thank you, Joel. We've also been really encouraged by stories of some of you raising money for people who don't have as much money. So Ben has been raising money for Burundi, which is the poorest country in the world, where they don't get healthcare, doctors and nurses for free. So he's been able to send money to them so that they can get medical care for free. Absolutely brilliant. Thank you, Ben. And Bethany and Joseph have been saving up their pocket money so they could buy a whole week's food shop for kids who don't have enough money for food at their school. So thank you so much, Bethany and Joseph. It's really great to hear.
And talking about raising money, Ezra, who's watching all the way from Japan, hi Ezra, he's been being sponsored for memorizing Bible verses.
Amazing.
He's raised so much money that he's sending 50 Bibles all the way over to China, and so that's really exciting as well.
Well done, Ezra. Well, you'll like this one, Andy. On the point of doing fundraising, Jonah is doing a sponsored silence all the way through Lent. So he is going to be only able to say 10 sentences a day, with a day off each week, for the whole of Lent. So if you do see him, make sure he's being quiet. So well done, Jonah.
I don't think I could do that.
No,
I think
I'd
struggle. And guys, for those of you who have sent in some stories, we're going to be sending you one of these t-shirts, Trent Kids t-shirts, and definitely keep those stories coming in. They're
absolutely
amazing.
Yeah, definitely. Well, it's that time of the week now.
Oh no.
For the Colour Captain Challenge. And this is really like a bottom of the table playoff.
It is.
You're on 2 stars, aren't you?
Yeah, and you're on 2 stars.
Yeah,
as well.
Yeah. So this is it.
It's all to play for.
Absolutely. Well, let's go to the Welcome to the Colour Captain Challenge, where we do some pretty ridiculous things to keep ourselves safe from gunging. So we're going to be hearing from the Challenge Master, but I mean, we really need to. Well, one of us needs to start winning stuff.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping it's going to be me.
Well, me too, obviously.
Yeah. But, I mean, who is the Challenge Master anyway? I've still not figured this out.
No idea, but I know that we don't get gunged if we can guess who he is. And that's what I'm kind of gunning for, really, you
okay.
know.
Well, I'm gunning to win it.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah. Well, fighting talk.
But we're pretty close, aren't we?
I know. We're both on 2 stars. Someone's got to win and it gets us someone safe. So. And it gets the other one, you know, in a bit of mess. So, I think, without further ado, let's hear from the Challenge Master.
Greetings, Colour Captains. I am the Challenge Master.
Challenge Master, where are you?
Yeah, it looks like there's lots of fancy science equipment behind you.
You're filled with disgusting stuff.
Ugh.
Ah, yes. You have found me in my cellar, looking through my collection of pickled herrings. I've been sampling some of the smelliest. See
what's suitable for this year's end-of-term gunge. This delightful 5-year-old vintage is crispy. Well, speaking of gunge, I'd actually quite like to avoid getting gunged. I know Andy would too. So I've actually got a guess about your identity.
Oh, you have a guess as to my identity? Well, this should be interesting.
Well, I've noticed that you wear a top hat. You've got a magical umbrella, and I've heard that your favourite song is Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, so I think you're Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins. Oh dear. You see, Colour Captains, I have been deeply impressed with how well you have thrown yourself into my challenges. You have indeed exceeded all of my expectations with your marvellous, marvellous talents. But when it comes to guessing my identity, I'm afraid your efforts have been sadly lacking. I think it's time to get you some help.
You mean like a super intelligent bionic dog that can tell the future?
No. No. A group of people far, far cleverer than that. Greetings, children. I am the Challenge Master. Now I know that all of you at home, you're more than smart enough to work out my identity. So here's what I need you to do. If you think you know who I am, write it down in an email and send it into kids@trentvineyards.org. Make sure to include on your email who you would like to give immunity to, should your guess be correct.
Well, I'm looking forward to this because I'm clearly everyone's favourite.
What? No, I'm everyone's favourite.
Well, I'm the one who's got all the fan mail come through over lockdown.
Well, look, let's both agree it's definitely not Josh.
Yeah, fair.
Agreed.
Well, we shall see. Are you ready for this morning's challenge?
Yeah!
Very good. This morning we will be testing your ability to jump around and headbang with the best of them. So I have provided you with a special hat with a pedometer attached. That special device will count the number of times you shake your head back and forth. There will be some pounding music and I expect to see some impressive headbanging. The colour captain with the most headbangs at the end of the time is the winner. The colour captain with the fewest headbangs is the loser. And I'm afraid one step closer to a glorious ganjin.
Okay, so I get it now. We've got our challenge. We've just got a headbang as if our lives depended on it.
Right, yeah. So I'm definitely taking these off then because I beat Josh last time I did that.
Oh, well, that's a good point. Well, I'm going to do my stand-up technique because I'm not going to be sitting down doing this.
Well, I'm going to join you then. And actually, I might have an air guitar because I think that'll be, you know, nice. More enthusiastic.
You'll be in it. Right, is mine on zero?
Yeah, is mine?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, well, let's do a 5-second countdown with you guys at home. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go! Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Stop.
How are you feeling?
Very dizzy.
Oh.
I can barely stand up. Is that the floor or the ceiling?
I'm not sure anymore, but I'm pretty sure we looked quite ridiculous there. So shall we go and see some replays? Oh man, those replays were pretty ridiculous.
I know, I've definitely got some faces that I wish weren't on the internet.
same here. And how are you feeling now?
I've got a ringing going on actually at the minute, so it's...
I think my brain's actually moved inside, like it's different now to before. Oh man.
Well, the results are in.
Go on then.
96.
What? No.
I did, look, 96.
What? I literally got 96 as
no.
well.
No!
Yeah! That's what are the odds?
What is the chances of that?
Well, fine. Okay, well, what happens now if we draw?
Do we share the points?
I think that's what it is. Half a point each, maybe? Yeah.
Great. Shall we see where we are on the scoreboard? So, we were both on 2 points, and now it looks like we're both on 2.5, so that means that Dan... He's at the bottom, isn't he?
He's in the danger zone, definitely. And we're a little bit safer.
We are, definitely. And Beth, I think we could catch her. She's only on 3.
Yeah,
so only half a point.
One more challenge and we're in.
Could be. Thank you, Challenge Master. It was a great challenge. I actually really enjoyed it. Guys, if you think you know who the Challenge Master is, send us an email. It'd be really great to hear from you all.
Yeah, and now we're going to go to worship, which is led by the dance team. So we're probably going to want to get up and dance with the dance team. Let's go to worship.
Your love is wild for me. Wild for me. Your love is wild for me. You gave it all for me. Now I believe your love is wild for me. Coming for my heart when I'm wandering, tearing down the lies of the enemy. Your love is wild, God is wild for me. Oh, your love is wild, God is wild for me. There is a love that's calling out my name, raising me from death into life again, speaking spoken to my soul of its destiny. Your love is wild, God is wild for me. Oh, your love is wild, God is wild for me. Your love is wild for me, wild for me. Your love is wild for me. You gave it all for me. Now I believe your love is wild for me. There is a love that's calling out my name, raising me from death into life again, speaking to my soul of its destiny. Your love is wild, God is wild for me. Oh, your love is wild, God is wild for me. Your love is wild for me, wild for me. Your love is wild for me. You gave it all for me. Now I believe your love is wild for me. Yeah. Your love for me cannot be tamed. Your love for me will never fail. Your love for me is victory. Oh, your love is wild for me. Your love for me cannot be tamed. Your love for me will never fail. Your love for me is victory. Oh, your love is wild for me. Oh, your love is wild for me.
There's a love like a lion roaring from my heart. His desire like a fire, we will never be apart. We're no longer orphans, children of the King. To him I give my life, I give my everything. Cause Jesus loves you, Jesus loves me. He died and rose again to give us victory. I was born to make a difference, born to be free. Born to know this God, his love is wild for me.
Your love is wild for me. Wild for me, your love is wild for me. You gave it all for me. Now
remember to keep the Sabbath as a holy day. You may work and get everything done during 6 days each week, but the seventh day is a day of rest to honour the Lord your God.
I will give rest and strength to those who are weak and tired.
So today we're continuing to look at things that we can do each day that will help us grow to be more like Jesus, with a funny sounding thing called Sabbath.
It's called Sabbath. And the reason it's a bit of a strange word is because it's a Hebrew word from the Old Testament of the Bible. But it just means a day of rest. It means every week setting aside a day where you don't do any work, where you enjoy the things that God has given you.
And the idea of a day of rest actually goes back to the first few pages of the Bible. There we read that God created out of nothing the world, the stars, the plants, the animals, and even humans. He did this all in just 6 days, and then on the seventh day, he stopped. He sat back and enjoyed all that he had made. God declared this seventh day a holy day, a special day, one which all his people should join with him in celebrating each week, a day that would deeply bless those who took the time to enjoy it.
And so taking a day of rest each week just like God did, became an important part in the lives of God's people. In fact, it was so important that God even included it in the Ten Commandments.
Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you, nor your son, nor your daughter, nor your cousins, or their cousins, or the cousins, or the friends of their cousins, or any robot dogs that you've got that are super smart that can tell the future. They shouldn't do any work either. Nor shall the internet, the people on the internet, they work hard. They don't do work either, none of them. No one does any work.
So taking a day off each week where we don't do work and we can focus on celebrating God and all the good things he gives us is a really important thing for God's friends to be doing. But why? Why does God care how much rest we get?
Well, let's think for a second about the tech that we might have. I'm sure lots of you watching might have a phone or a tablet or a Switch or something like that. Now, as we all know, if we're constantly using these items, eventually the battery will run down and they'll stop working altogether. In order for our tech to keep working properly, we need to make sure that we regularly charge them. You need to plug them in and then leaving them for a bit so the battery can charge up. Once you do that, they'll be good to go.
And it's the same with us. We are not designed to always be working. Just like our tech, we need to make sure we regularly stop and recharge. And the way God designed us to do that is by taking a day off each week.
And in the past, we were quite good at that. In this country, most workplaces and shops were closed each Sunday, so people didn't have the option to work every day. Instead, they could go to church and then enjoy the good things that God has given them.
What an absolutely beautiful day, Horace.
Isn't it?
But now, very few people take the day off each week. Many choose to work a bit of each day.
And the results are not good. People are getting grumpier, more tired, more stressed, and further away from God. It's not how God designed us to be.
So taking a day of rest each week is really important. For most of us, because we have to go to school during the week, that day is most likely to be a Saturday or a Sunday. So what should that day look like?
Well, as we read earlier, one of the main things that we need to do on our day of rest is not work. This means no jobs, no work, no finishing off homework, and it also means avoiding doing our chores or tidying on our Sabbath days. It should be a day completely free of any boring work.
Now, before you get too excited, we're not saying that you shouldn't do homework or chores. We're just saying that in order to take the day off, you need to work really hard during the week to make sure that all your homework and jobs are done before you take your day off. This might mean that you need to make some sacrifices in order to finish your work on the other days, but it's definitely worth it.
So that's what we shouldn't do on our day of rest. But in the New Testament, Jesus helps us understand that the day of rest is more about the good things we should do than the bad things we shouldn't. So let's look at a few good things that we should do on our days of rest. As we said earlier, God made the Sabbath a holy day, which is where we get the word holiday from. Holiday, holy day. So the best way to think about our day of rest is as a holiday each week. So we should look to do the same kind of things that we would do on our holidays in our Sabbath, such as
going on adventures outside,
playing our favourite sports,
reading some of our favourite books,
spending time with friends and family,
or eating some of our favourite food,
and just generally relaxing.
God wants us to use our day of rest to enjoy all of the great things that he's given us. He doesn't want us worrying about what's coming up or thinking about what we don't have. He just wants us to make the most of all the amazing things that he's given us.
So get creative. Plan to do fun things with your day of rest. Don't just do the things you always do, but instead make sure that your Sabbath day is the highlight of your week. But there's something else we also need to consider when planning our days off.
Another really important part of our day off is spending time with God.
God wants to enjoy our days off with us. He doesn't want us to do them separate from Him.
For lots of Christians, they might go to church on their day of rest to spend time with God and worship Him. Obviously, at the moment, that's a bit tricky. But you could just as easily set some time aside on your Sabbath day to watch Trent Kids or read your Bible.
In fact, your Sabbath gives a great opportunity for you to try out all of the spiritual practices that we've been talking about so far this term. So we'd really encourage all of you to use your day of rest to get to know your Bibles better, to spend time talking and listening to God, to practice generosity, to worship, to be thankful, and to ask the Holy Spirit to fill you up. I guess what we're trying to say is make sure to take a Sabbath day each week and use your day of rest to enjoy the things that God's given you, but also to enjoy God. To focus on the things that are really important and to realize how amazing our Father God really is.
That is so great to hear, that God loves us so much that He actually created a specific time for us to rest so that we could enjoy Him and enjoy the good things that He's given to us.
Yeah, and just to hear about the importance of rest as well, and that also that it's not just about necessarily doing nothing and, yeah. and actually taking time, but actually it's about maybe doing something different. Yeah. You can do something fun. Yeah. I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't know if you've noticed this, Andy, or you have had a similar experience. But for me, definitely as I've got older, it's got harder to keep that kind of Sabbath rest time.
Definitely.
And so I guess we would say to you guys, it's really, really worth getting that space right now while you're young, because it gets harder as you get older.
Definitely. And doing things together as well. Don't just do it on your own, do it with your family. I think that's really important and it makes it a lot easier as well.
Yeah, that's it. And this is for something that you enjoy, that you're going to be... is it going to be helpful for you? So it's worth planning ahead of time.
Definitely.
How are you going to spend your next Sabbath? Maybe thinking about that with your family.
Great. Well, the big points for today are, one, God wants us to have a day of rest each week where we don't do any work, and the Bible calls this a Sabbath.
Number two, God wants us to use these days to slow down and enjoy all the good things He's given us.
And number three, we should also use these days to get to know God better and better.
So why don't we finish today's session with prayer? So you might want to close your eyes, and maybe we'll just start with a moment of quiet, just to focus our minds on God. And you might want to say some things to Him out loud, or you might want to just say them in your heart. Just to start connecting with God. Father, we thank You for Sabbath rest, that You cared for us so much that You wanted us to have space and time where we didn't have to do any work. And Lord, I just pray that You'd help us to protect that time. It's so valuable. And I pray, Lord, that You would help us to have great ideas of activities that would be restful and fun and would help us to get closer to You. And we just pray for this next Sabbath that we're having, and maybe for many of us it's today. Lord, we give it to You. And we say, Lord, make this Your Sabbath. In Jesus' name. Shall we do a big Trent Kids Amen?
Definitely.
Amen!
Well, guys. guys, that's it from us today. Today we've been learning about Sabbath and rest, and we hope you've had fun with us learning about that.
Yeah, and don't forget to keep sending us in your stories. We really love hearing from you, and you could be in with a chance of winning one of these Trent Kids t-shirts. We love you, we miss you, and we will see you next Sunday.
Sam, I've had an idea what I can carry on doing for Sabbath.
Really?
One sec.
What's he gonna...
Sam! I got stuck again.